results of YouTube. This video, I'm going to show you how to make a Dory house. So, from finding Dory and from finding Nemo. And if you want to make her, here's what you're going to need. You will need some block of quartz. You will need some purple wool, black wool, dark blue wool, yellow wool, red wool, sand, and some brown hardened clay or stained clay. And finally, guys, grab yourself some dark green wool. And we will need quite a few more materials a little later on, but for now, these are going to have to do it. So once you've got those materials right there, and once you figured out where you want to make her, and by the way, this is a dilemma because, of course, Dory is suspended in the air. It's how hot you want to low if you want to where you want to make her, but the higher you build her off the ground, the more weird it's going to look. So I'm gonna do like three sand coming up from the ground. 1, 2, 3. And I place 5 brown stained clay. So 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. And then on top of that, place a dark blue. But in case you are wondering what that brown stained clay is, we're just gonna do it to count it out. As I said, this is the first block of Dory. And then go left of her by 3. 1, 2, 3. Like so. Then do an up left diagonal. Then left by 1, then an up left diagonal. Go left by 2. Then 2 up left diagonals, that's 1 and 2, then left by 1. Do an up left diagonal and go left by 1. Go left by 2, but this time use your black wool. Then do 2 bottom left diagonals. Oops, that's 1 and 2. Then go left by 2. Then take out your yellow and go up by 8. So 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, and 8. Like that. Then place a black wall on top of that and go left of that by 2. And then do 2 bottom left diagonals. That's 1 and 2. I think that's a bottom right diagonal. And then anyways, go right by 1, then do a bottom right diagonal. Then go down by 2 with your yellow. 1, 2. Then right here, place a black wall. And then do two upright diagonals. That's 1 and 2. Then right by 1. Then do 2 upright diagonals. That's 1 and 2. Then go right by 1, then do a upright diagonal. Go right by 2. Do an upright diagonal and go left by 6. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, and 6. Then do a bottom right diagonal. Oops.
This, but it's getting a little dark, so we'll cut this out close to other again.
Then take out your old pal dark blue and go down by 3. 1, 2, 3. Then go right by 1, then go down by 2. Then go down each of these blocks by 1, 1, and 1, right like that. Then with this one, go down by 2. Then these two blocks by 1 again. Then do a bottom right diagonal with your red, like that. Then do a bottom right diagonal with your dark blue. Then down one, left one. Then two bottom left diagonals. That's one and two. Then left by one, then a bottom left diagonal, like that. And you should connect all the way back to where you first started. And you want a shape which should look like that. And then what we want to do is fill in her tail in with yellow wool. So I am going to do that right now because obviously Blue Tang's tails are yellow. Like that. Although you could add an additional row of black wool behind that, but I'm not gonna do that. If you want it to look more cooler, but I'm not gonna do that. And then once you've done that, it's time to finish building up Dory's body. Right here, place a dark blue and go less than by three. One, two, and three. And pretty much all we have to do is probably just trace. I think. Then what you want to do is place a two black wool right here. Right here. Two rows of yellow. That's one and two. Then stack a row of black. Then from this block, do a up left, up right diagonal. Then go right by one. Then two up right diagonals, that's one and two. Then go right by one. Then an up right diagonal. Then go right by two. Do an upright diagonal and go right by six. One, two, three, four, five, and six. Then do a bottom right diagonal, probably. Take out your dark blue and go down by two. Then go right by one. Take out your quartz and go down one and right one. Then place a dark blue and go back by one, I think. Then go right of it by one, then down by two. Then go right by one. Then go right by two. One and two. Then go down by one. Right here, place a bottom right diagonal. Then do three bottom right diagonals. One, two, and three. Like that. Go left by one, then do a bottom left diagonal, probably. But I think these are bottom right diagonals. Unfortunately, it's getting a little dark, so we'll cut this out when we have Glossier out again. Then we can go back like this. Kind of like that. Do an upright diagonal and go right by one. Do an up left diagonal and go right by two. Do an up left diagonal and go right by two again. I think. Actually, change this up. Do two up left diagonals, then go right by one. And then place four rows of black. One, two, three, and four. Then one and two, probably. your brother, Donald. No, actually, I was wrong. Go right by one. Yeah, I was right. One. And two. Like that. Then go right by one. Do an upright diagonal. And go right by two. Do an upright diagonal. And go right by three. One, two, three. Take out your dark blue and go right by three. One, two, three. Then go down by two. One, two. Then go right by two. One, two. Then go right by one with the dark blue and take out your quartz and go right by two. One, two. Then take out your purple wall and place two, then a dark blue. Although, actually I'm not going to use purple. I prefer to use magenta wool because her eyes are magenta-ish. That's better. No, actually I'm going to use purple for this one. I'm actually going to use purple. Purple. Anyways, place the purple walls right here. Then go down by one with the dark blue and go right by one with the dark blue. Go right by one with the block of quartz right here. Then do two dark blue right here. Take out your red and go to the bottom right diagonal like this. Go. Do a bottom left diagonal with your dark blue. Then go right to that by one. Then take out your dark blue and go down by two, like that. Then go down a bit by one. Then do a bottom left diagonal with that. Thing. I think it's kind of like that. Then left by one. Then do a bottom right, bottom left diagonal. Kind of like that. And you want something which should look like that, kind of. Then do an upward. Out with the diagonal from that right here. And what I noticed is getting a little dark, so we'll cut this out and go stay out again. Then go left of that by three. One, two, three. And this is all with dark blue, by the way. Do an up left diagonal, probably. Then left by one. And an up left diagonal. Like that. Go left by two. Do an up left diagonal. Then go up by four with your black. One, two, three, and four. Do an up right diagonal. Again. Then right by one. Then do an up left diagonal again. Up right diagonal. Not up left diagonal. Then right by two. Do an up left diagonal. Again, upright diagonal, and then one, two, three. Then go right by three. One, two, three. Oops. Then go right by two with your dark blue. One, two. Do and bottom right diagonal with your dark blue right here. Then do another because we meant to do two. So two bottom left diagonals like that. Then go right by one and up by one. Then go down. This block by five. One, two, three, four, and five. And a bottom left diagonal. Like that. Then left by one. Then do a bottom left diagonal again. To give you this shape. of Dory. Then, with this black ball right here, go down by two. One and two. Then, go right by one. Then a bottom left eye. Bottom left eye, I think. From that. Then go down by two with your black. One and two. Then a bottom left diagonal with your black, like that. And then go left until you connect all the way to her tail, like that. Then right on this block, we want to place a dark blue. Then down by one with your dark blue. Then left and right by one. Then down by one and go right, go left by three. One, two, and three. And then I think we have to fill this in with black wool. I'm pretty sure. I am pretty sure we have to fill this in with black. Kinda like that. Then fill the rest of the area in with dark blue wool. Probably. And then, and you want something which should look like that. Then we have to do her flipper. So, and to do that, we need to go right by two, I think. One, two. Up, outward by two. One, two. Then, come back by one. Then, come right to that block by one. Then we are to go up by one from this block right here. Then, place a black left of that. Then, go up by two with your black. One and two. Then do a diagonal with your yellow wool. Look kind of like that. Up by one, left by one with your yellow right here. Then go up by one.
Cut out?
Up. Now it's getting a little dark, so we'll cut this out right across here. So that is what you want for Dory's flipper right here. And once you've done that, we're going to copy the exact same thing that we did. So we're gonna place four dark blue right here, then two, then three, then one, then two, and two, I think. Then what you want to do is place two black wool right here, then two rows of yellow, one and two. Then stack a row of black. Then do an up left diagonal like that. Then left by one. Then two up left diagonals, that's one and two. Then left by one. Then do an up left diagonal. Then left by two. Do an up left diagonal and go right by six. One, two, three, four, five, six. Then do a bottom left diagonal with the black. Then down by two with the dark blue. Then left by one. Then down by one with the block of quartz. Then left by one with the block of quartz. Then place a dark blue wool right here. Then place another one right here. Then go right to that dark blue by one. Then take this dark blue wool and go down a bit by two. Then go left by one right here. Then go backwards to your red wool by two. One, two. Then we want to place a bottom left diagonal from that. Then do a bottom left diagonal with your dark blue like this. Then three bottom right diagonals, one, two, and three. then right by one, and then do a bottom right diagonal and to connect back to where you first started. And you want a shape which should look like that. But we have two more things right now with her. But it's getting a little dark, so we'll cut this out when we're close to it again. And then what we want to do is do the same thing, but diagonally. Like this. Do an upright diagonal, right by one. Do an upright diagonal and go right by two. Two upright diagonals, one and two. Then right by one. I think. On top of these two dark blues, we will place four rows of black. One, two, three, and four. Then do two up left diagonals. One and two. Go left by one, then do an up left diagonal. Then left by two, do an up left diagonal, and go right by three. One, two, three. Then probably take out your dark blue and go left by three, like that. Then go left by, down by two. Take the middle block and come in forward by two. One and two, like that. Take that second block and go right by one, like that. Then left by two with your quartz. Then you want to place a purple wall and go right a bit by one. Right of the dark blue by one, like that. Then block down by one with the dark blue, left by one with the dark blue, and left by one with the quartz. Then do a bottom left diagonal, probably with your dark blue. Then place another. Then do an outward diagonal with your red wall, like that. Then a bottom left diagonal with your dark blue, like that. Then left by one. Then down by one with your dark blue. Then go down by two with this one. One and two. Then do a bottom right diagonal right here. Then right by one. Then do a bottom right diagonal and connect back where you first started, like that. Then do an upwards, outwards diagonal with the dark blue. Then go right by three with your dark blue. One, two, three. Then do an upright diagonal and go right by one. Do an upright diagonal, go right by two. Do two upright diagonals, one and two. Hold on a second. Oops, I meant to do this. Go up with your dark blue by four. One, two, three, and four. Then an up left diagonal. Then left by one, upright diagonal. I meant up left diagonal and go right by two. Do an up left diagonal and go right by three. One, two, and three. Then continue going left by two with the dark blue. One and two. Then two bottom left diagonals. One and two. Oops. Then left by one and up by one. Take this block and go down by five. One, two, three, four, and five. But it's getting a little dark, so we'll cut this out and go to that again. Then do a bottom right diagonal. Then go right by one. Do a bottom right diagonal. And that should continue and let you back where you first started. Then go down by two with the black. One and two. Then left by one. Then do a bottom left diagonal. Then down by two. Then do a bottom right diagonal. Then go right until you connect back on yourself to that black wall. Then you want to go right by one with the dark blue right here. Then down by one. Then right and left by one. Then down by one and probably left by three, right by three. One, two, and three. Then fill in the empty spaces in with your black wall and the rest of the space with dark blue. So I'm going to film this in time lapse. Then do Doi's Flipper exactly like how we did earlier. So do this. Go two. Outwards two. Then go right on that second dark blue by one. Then go on top of it by one. Then left of it by one. Then you want to place a black wall right here. Then go on top of it by two. One, two. Right here you want to place a yellow. Then on top of it by one. Then left by, right by one, on top of it by one. But this is Dory looking a little bit creepy for my taste. And we need to get rid of the dark blue. We need the quartz and the dark blue carpet. So where is the dark blue carpet? There you are. And we don't need the black anymore. And we want to place the black wall right here. No, the block of quartz right here and there. Then we want to add dark blue carpet on top of her eyelids. So let's make a sand background, and then we can get rid of these brown stained clay, can't we? And then what you want to do is make a sand temple that goes all the way around door. It's getting a little dark, so we'll cut this out where I'm ghost out again. And what I'm also doing is knocking out a little bit of the floor because I'm going to add a little bit of water to it to make it look like a pool. Goes all the way around. Which is pretty cool.
You give it to me later.
And right here. Then I'm gonna get out my bucket of water, but if you're wondering what the previous one was, those were from the Dunkin' Donuts build. Fill it in with water. Put in water everywhere. just going all the way around and taking our time. Like this, I think. And once I've done that, I'm gonna add some probably kelp to this thing, because obviously kelp in the ocean. We need some dark green wool, brown stained clay, and some lime green wool. Then I'm gonna add a little plush shape to it, probably. Like this, then place a dark green wall on top of that, then probably add four to it. 1, 2, 3, 4, like that. Then on the fourth block, go left by one, then three upwards. 1, 2, 3, and probably go up the other one by 5. 1, 2, 3, 4, and 5, like that. And go back of it by 3. 1, 2, 3. And I'm gonna do that on the other side.
Free vacation to Orlando.
Then place a dark green wall. I'm gonna do that again. 1, 2, 3, 4. And go up by 3. 1, 2, 3. And go do an up left eye. Oh. Kind of like that. Oh no, that's not a good idea. I'm gonna keep it like this. Then I'm gonna add another one right here, like so. 1, 2, 3, 4. Then up left diagonal. And go right by 4. 1, 2, 3, and 4. Like that. I might add some coral to it. So we'll use pink. Probably a little bit of orange. We will probably need a little bit of magenta. And I think that might be it. I think the core will be like this. 2, 3, up, probably will be like this. I'm gonna go back with this way. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. Oh, we'll forget about it. I will add Peach to it, probably. You know her from the Tank Gang. Peach will be right here. Oops. No, not right here. This will be the best place to do this. I don't know. Probably. I will need probably some item frames for her eyes. And probably wither skulls. I think you could use black wool or wither skulls. If you choose. Oh, that's not what I want. That's painting. And place her eyes right here. And make her mouth like that. Actually, no. Let's keep her like this. And I think we'll add a couple fish around Eudoria. We'll add two more. We'll add two fish around her, and I will show you the regional version, which this thing will be boasted a little bit. Ooh, forgot we also need our white walls for the eyes. But it's getting a little dark, so we'll cut this out where we have glorious daylight again. Then you want to place a orange wool and go probably like this. Kind of like that, maybe. And then we can get rid of these orange walls, can we? We're just going to have to count it out. How about right here? Then two layers of orange after that. One and two, like that. Then do three layers on the back, right here. One, two, three. Do the same thing to make it look like there's an eye shape, like that. Then place this right here, outward diagonals, like this. Kind of like that. But you can probably delete some of these blocks on the left and right if you want it more squarey, kind of like that. And we can add a red wall, like around here. We can delete the two diagonals from the red wall, then replace them with white wall, place the eye tip frames, then the eyes, like that. And if you want this thing to make more look like Nemo, you could use like more like black wool and place a white wool right here. Then you can make a flipper right here on top of the fish. And then another one right here, probably. No, we will use probably use this in the center, then we'll use the orange. Kind of like this. No, probably will look good like this. Then I'm going to use a purple fish. Then we will do the same thing. Probably like 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Then we can delete these. I'll be back in a moment, but I won't tutorial it. So, Papa, can you please come here?
Did you build Dory?
Yeah, will you please help me?
Holy mackerel, dude.
You'll please help me, right, Papa?
Yeah, what's up?
So, you'll always help, right?
Sure, of course. What do you got there?
We got Dory, obviously, right?
That is amazing.
Do you know who that is?
That's Nemo.
So do you think we should add more characters to this thing? But I won't show you that, because I'll just show you the original version of it.
Yeah, I think that is pretty awesome, dude.
Do you think you should help me after Mama gets home?
Sure.
Okay.
Alright.
And that is the Dory house completed. Mama?
Mm-hmm.
Mama, sit. Ready? And Mama? Look. Look, Mama. Mama, look. Hey, kids say, don't forget to mash that like button.
Leave a comment down below.
Subscribe.
Tell your friends about Meeker Loves Sharks HD on YouTube.
And we see you next time out here.
I'm Meeker Loves Sharks.
HD. Check us out on Instagram.
At MLS 16.
And when I was the honest video,
you gonna get some of this.
You know, said Dory will turn Eve.
She was gonna turn evil?
Yeah.
Awful.
I simulated, as you can see, I simulated Destiny, Bruce, and the other three sharks, and all the characters, except for Becky and the sea lions, and say, thanks for watching. See you guys next time.
Bye. It's me, Crew, love sharks, H2.